vibes or a lesson, please?
Why not both?
And if you don't play guitar, please stay tuned because I've got a story behind the music. It's kind of funny how the title actually came about. It was right after I launched my YouTube channel, Analyzed Within. And, you know, back then on the YouTube channel, you know, they had it laid out a little bit differently so you could, like, put banners on the sides if you want to, if you position the picture just right. So I had on one side Analyzed Within, and I thought, well, I'd like to have something on the other side, too. And so I'm like, what could be a good one? And back then, I didn't even have an idea of what I might call my EP in the coming months, which never actually came to be anyway. But I thought, well, let's see, Inside of Me, that sounds cool, I'll just do that. Why Inside of Me? Well, this, I guess, you know, maybe I was just thinking from a spiritual standpoint. Inside of Me, I'm telling you what, you know, it's just like musically, this is what I'm gonna tell you about or something. It was just gonna be instrumental stuff, but I just thought, well, that's a cool random name. So Inside of Me became just a random little side banner that was on the side and never was used for anything except for this song. Whenever I came to this song, I wrote the song. As I was starting to write the song, I thought, oh, it sounds kind of cool and deep and emotional, so I'll call that Inside of Me. So it's just kind of a working title right now. I don't know if this song is going to stay this title, but for the meantime, I definitely want to let you know, not only in this guitar lesson are you going to get a free backing track that I made especially for you, and of course the tablature, then I'm also going to give you the track that's been recorded for a long time and me and my bandmates have been listening to, something that we will re-record one day, but it's an MP3 download of the full song of Inside of Me, How It Stands Today. I just basically re-recorded just that bridge guitar solo part for that specific YouTube video. So that's the only thing that's been re-recorded. So you can hear, it's going to be a very old mix, so it's not something I'm really happy with, but it's a very warm mix. So in any case, that is the story. Let's go ahead and get to the lesson. Alright, so when you download the tablature, you can load it up in Tux Guitar or Guitar Pro. It should work in there as well. I wrote it in Tux Guitar. It's T-U-X Guitar, just like a tuxedo. So that should load up for you. And I did write this song on an 8-string, but I know that most people don't have 8-strings. Most people have like 6-strings and stuff. So I try to keep it more universal. And even the rhythms are in 6-string form. So no matter what you have, you can just tune like to drop D, because that's what we're in right now. So we start out on the E string, 10th fret. We're gonna slide up and pull off. Go down to the E, B, and G string. And then we're gonna pull off and hammer on. And go back to the B string. We're playing this theme twice because this is what the theme sounds like. So you play this twice here. And still on the B string, we're on the 8th fret. Then we switched to the G string there, so on the frets, the B string, there's 8, 7, and then 7 on the G string after that. Alright, and then after that we're going to be on the 6th fret, still the G string, for this next part here. You're going to bend up a half a step. And then you're going to, with the notes still ringing, you're just going to tap on the 13th fret, still on the G string. And then pull that off there and go back to the 6th, just normal. And while that note is still ringing, just bend up a half a step one more time to the 7th and back to the 6th. Normal note range, and then go down to 4, so. And if you're, you know, if you're comfortable enough with it, you could even not even pick on that last note on the 4 like I did in just a moment ago. Okay, so I'll show you this section one more time. Okay, so there's the first part, and then after this, we're going to kind of repeat the theme again, except with a little twist. So all we really did was pretty much just went up a string to the E string, and then we're playing this twice again, you know, so here it goes, except the second time that you play it in this part, we go all the way up to the 21st fret on the G string, but I'll show you that here. So it goes. And that can be a little challenging to hit sometimes, because what you're doing is, as soon as you're finished with that this little section up here, you're immediately sliding all the way up to the 21st fret, doing a full bend, letting go, and then going to the 19th fret for a vibrato. And right there, I almost missed it. I almost was short. So that's something that you run into as far as, you know, you come a little too short, or sometimes a little too over the 21st fret, so you just really have to practice to get that just right. And then you're still up here on the very last part of the solo. You are on the 20th fret here on the B string. And you go to the 19th fret. So you'll notice that's the same picking pattern as when we were down here on the 7th fret. We're just on the 19th fret now. G string. And then we're gonna play around with some bends right here. We're on the 18th fret and G string. So you're just bending up a half a step, just like if you were playing the 19th fret, but you're on the 18th fret, G string, just bending up halfway. Then 14, 16 on the G string, ending with a really cool vibrato. Okay, now moving on to the rhythm guitar section. This is really fun to play, especially in drop D, because in drop D you hear all the intricacies that you may not really hear on a 8 string tuned down really low. Even a 7 string would play this as well. But like I said, we're in drop D. This is an octave higher than how I normally played it on the 8 string. Okay, so now we're going to play that slower. So this chord is just utilizing, it's the same as a power chord you might use, you know, on the 9th fret, except you're adding a voicing instead of, it's this. Now this next part kind of has a halftime feel, so it's the same chords as you've been playing, it's just that it's a different rhythm. So I'll kind of break it down for you here. I'm going to go ahead and play it first. Alright, so what we're doing is we've got the note that's ringing out, and then we're playing part of the chord at the bottom, so that's what you're hearing me play. I'm playing that with an upstroke. And those two notes are dead notes. You kind of just mute them out. They've got their own tone, obviously, because you're on that one part of the fretboard, but it's basically a dead note. And you're sliding up there. And that can take some practice if you're not used to doing that. It can be a little challenging, but it's definitely possible. So if that's hard for you, don't give up. It's fun to play when you actually get it. And slide down to our normal chords that we're at. And that, you add just another part of the upstroke at the last part there real fast, and you'll see in the tablature how it's broken down. Now the real song doesn't end like that, but since it's the guitar solo bridge that you're learning, I've customized this lesson around that portion. So one more time, I'll go ahead and show you this whole bit here. So now we're going to go ahead and build the backing track. This will be for your benefit so you can see the full demo of the rhythm guitar and the solo guitar as well. And now it's time to record the guitar solo. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed this guitar lesson, and if you did, please check out more of my guitar lessons here, and let me know if you have any requests for any future songs that I do. And also, if you want to check out behind the scenes that I do occasionally on my Instagram, I'm always posting there, and it's at Brandon D. Birch. So go follow me there if you like that kind of stuff. Y'all have a great one.